the River Road Senior Choir for performing our prelude music today. It's beautiful. Wonderful, wonderful job. I'm so glad that so many of you are already eating. Please feel free to continue to do so. If you are not eating yet, you are welcome to get in line. The serving lines are open, and you will want to eat quickly because you will want to go and check out the silent auction items that we have today. We have some great, great silent auction items. We certainly appreciate our incredible sponsors for giving to those and allowing us to kick off the interfaith campaign so well. So thanks to a couple of our sponsors of silent auction items, Amarillo Family Eye Care, Mackenzie Weir, OD, it's my optometrist, CB Boutique, Enchanted Forest, The Garden of Natural Health, Hipskin Autoglass, Little Brown House, Top Notch Outfitters, Toys Boutique, Passion and Purpose Boutique, Goodens Jewelry, Mackie Black Boutique, Silverland, Corbin's, Berlin Pie and Imperial Tap Room, 575, Wonderland, Deluxe Nails, Panhandlers Cafe, and J. Boone Jewelry donated by Stacy Gatlin. So thanks again to all of our silent auction contributors today. Go and check out that great stuff. The silent auction is going to be open until 12:45. 12:45 exactly and on the nose. So if you're one of those, you know, hover around the silent auction items you want, you have to do that until 12:45. So just see. We'll get more acquainted in just a few minutes. Please enjoy your eating, enjoy your food, get in line if you haven't already. Lots of people to feed and we want to be very respectful of your time today, so please eat and enjoy and we'll get more of it in just a few minutes.
Thank you.
Welcome to the 21st annual Beans and Cornbread Luncheon. Thank you so much for being here, for giving a part of your day on this beautiful Monday that we have to be here and to support this great cause. I know that many of you are eating or have already eaten. That is precisely what we are supposed to be doing. The soup is delicious. Everyone try the soup. We have Desperados to thank for this wonderful meal today. So big thanks to Desperados catering. You can judge a person by their cornbread. Theirs is very good. So thanks to them. Thanks to Richard Dyer and the staff there of Desperados. We certainly appreciate their continued commitment to this great event. Our program will begin in just a couple of moments, so you still have time to hop through the line there, grab yourself some beans, some cornbread, some stew, and get back to your table. I know many of you have been through the line at the silent auction. We have that going. A unique opportunity with the silent auction today because it's just a great way to kick off this campaign. Thanks again to our silent auction donors, including Balfour Optical. That's a correction I had to make from earlier. Balfour Optical, we appreciate it. You have until 12:45 to check out the silent auction, so you have plenty of time to do that. All the donations, of course, that we raised through that silent auction today go to help us reach our goal of $150,000. So that will go a very long way in helping this campaign. You have very likely noticed the beautiful centerpieces that are on your tables. Discuss with your table mates. You will be taking those new plant friends home with you. They are $10. They're just 10 bucks. So if you guys, you know, you want like a joint custody agreement, now's the time to start working that out. $10 donation will get you that beautiful plant friend. The envelopes for that donation are on the table already. Volunteers will come by and get those envelopes from you later, so you can just leave them there on that table. They will collect them. Thanks to Irwin's Greenhouse for donating these beautiful centerpieces for us today. All these little plant friends, we just appreciate them so much. Together for the Interfaith Campaign for the Homeless Beans and Cornbread Luncheon. This is the one event annually, every year, where so many of these community agencies come together in collaboration to raise money and awareness for those who experience homelessness or who are at risk for homelessness in our community. And this year, we even have the Amarillo Police Department helping to serve, helping to usher and to guide in. Yeah, give them a round of applause. And protect and serve beans and cornbread sometimes, and you know, whatever else the community calls on them to do. So big thanks to them for their help today as well. We do want to invite you to give generously today. Give as generously as you possibly can, and I'll tell you why. This is a great, great investment in your dollar today, in whatever you can possibly give. All of the donations that we raise today, all of them, will be matched by the Catherine E. Brady Fund, which is a component fund of the Amarillo Area Foundation, up to $150,000. So the Interfaith Campaign for the Homeless has an incredible opportunity today to really make the dollars that are given today count. So keep that in mind as you're considering giving to this great organization and giving to this great cause. Another great component of this luncheon today, of the opportunity that we have to give, is that 100% of the donations will go directly to serving those who experience homelessness, are experiencing homelessness, or are at risk of homelessness here in our community. 100% of the funds. There is no overhead in this luncheon, and that really matters to me, especially going into the holidays. It matters where my donation is going. It matters that the money that I give is going exactly to the person who I want to give it to, and this is a great opportunity to take part in that. If you are writing a check today, there is a handy-dandy little placard on your table that will tell you more, but you can make your check payable to the Beans and Cornbread, courtesy of or care of the Amarillo Area Foundation, or AAF. You can put your donation, checks or cash, in those envelopes. And again, you don't have to hand those to anyone. Just put it in there. Somebody will pick it up later. So you don't have to actually, you know, track someone down. So again, please continue to eat and drink and be merry. And thank today. Our program will start in just about 10-ish minutes, so you have a little bit of time to wrap up your meal and to wrap up the silent auction bidding that I see is happening back there. We have just a few more minutes, so make sure you get your food and our seeds.
Thank you.
first annual Beans and Cornbread Luncheon, something we do year to year to help our community. We have a unique opportunity, I think, today to be here, especially as an interfaith coalition of people, in light of recent events, in light of this weekend, in light of the shooting at the synagogue in Pittsburgh. And I think it can give us great perspective to think how lucky we are, how fortunate we are, how blessed we are to be able to gather here together and to do something worthwhile in our community. So thank you for giving part of your Monday to this. Thank you for being here for your lunch hour. I trust everyone has been through the line. Everyone's kind of getting through there. That's perfect. You're doing exactly what you should be doing. So everything is going according to plan. My name is Jackie Kingston. I am a news anchor at KAMR Local 4. I anchor the news in the evenings. I am delighted to be here. I have known that homelessness and hunger go hand in hand in our community since I moved here, math on stage, 15 years ago, almost. I've known that because my first job was at the Maverick Boys and Girls Club, and I worked at the Hamlet branch, and our kids were hungry in the evenings. And we luckily were able to feed them, and many of those kids didn't know where they were going to go home at night. So those things go hand in hand. And empowering people through food and empowering them through a safe place to go at night is a benefit to our community. And so how lucky are we to be here today, to be working together hand in hand to help do what we can to end homelessness in our community. I'm so glad that you're here today. I do want to encourage you to please keep in mind that your donations are being matched by the Catherine E. Brady Fund today. It's an important thing that we're doing here, and the reverberations of your dollar, of what you are able to give today, go further than if you were just able to give them any other day. So please keep that in mind today as we go throughout the program. Reverend Murray Nelson is here to bless our food for us. Reverend Murray? He just said to just call me Murray, but everyone knows him. Just Murray, right?
It's easy to pray about this because the Lord cares about the homeless and He cares about those who are poor. So let us pray. Lord Jesus, we thank You for Your presence here. We thank You that Your loving kindness indeed never ceases. Your compassion never fails. They are new each morning. Great is Your faithfulness. Lord, we understand that You relate to homelessness. You were homeless in the person of Your Son, Jesus. You wandered as well, and folks reached out to You. Lord, we are grateful that You've reached out to us. We thank You, Lord, that every good gift we have comes from Your hand. The food we've enjoyed here today, the relationships around the table, and those that love us, every person that cares for us, Lord, is a representative of Your hand and Your care and Your love. So what we think of the groups represented here, just hearing Barb talk about some of these different folks and all the different gifts and talents and folks that are gifted and are called to this ministry and service in this community. We are so blessed to be a part of something where Your hand is so clearly at work. So Lord, we ask that You would motivate us again to care for the least of these, those folks that You have a special love for, and we're grateful for the many different folks that, again, are called to this ministry and serve. Lord, thanks for the food. Thank You for the time here together today. We ask that You receive all the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
That You have made this a priority to be here today, not just for the good food, but certainly for the good fellowship that you're enjoying at your tables. Most importantly, I am glad that you're here in order to bring awareness and impact to the issue of what we're here to talk about today. And it's important for us as a city to embrace this. And we are, I can tell, by the room full of people that are here. I'm so grateful for the committee members who have been planning this event for months. And in addition to that, they don't just do this event. Many of them are tied in to taking care of homeless and people who are in need of food in our community and across the panhandle. So they do this out of their hearts. They do it out of their calling, and I'm so grateful for the time and the dedication that they've given to put this event on. So with that, welcome. Thank you so very much for making this a priority, and we look forward to the rest of our program today. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Nelson. Thank you for those words of introduction. Now I'd like to welcome Barbara Witten and John Paul and Anastas. Man, I've been working on that and messed it up. Bobby. Worked on it all weekend. And here we are. They are the co-chairs of the Interfaith Campaign for the Homeless. Please come up and just tell us a little bit more about this great event and what we're kicking off today.
Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for being here. And we're going to talk a little bit about the last campaign, the results of the last campaign. But I just want to say that I got involved in this because I went on an agency tour. And if you ever have a chance to go on an agency tour, I hope you will do that. It was when I saw, when I understood the depth of the problem, and I saw the work that was being done by all these wonderful agencies that I got involved. So last year we had a great campaign. The agencies that received funding from last year, from your generous support, was Amarillo Area CASA, Amarillo Housing First, Amarillo ISD Families and Transition Program, Amarillo Recovery from Alcohol and Drugs, which is also known as ARAD, Another Chance House, Catholic Charities Pearl Longvine Emergency Youth Shelter, City of Refuge, the Downtown Women's Center, Evelyn Sunshine Cottage, Faith City Mission, Family Support Services Safe House, the Guyon Saunders Resource Center, Life Challenge, Martha's Home, the Panhandle Adult Rebuilding Center, also known as the PARC, the Salvation Army, and Sharing Hope Ministries for Patsy's Place. Now, these agencies provide many important services, but I want to tell you just a few examples of what they provide. Shelter, food, and clothing for neglected or abused children as young as 5 years old. A high-quality treatment program for drug or alcohol addicted adults who are currently living in one of our shelters. A modest but safe refuge for victims of domestic violence and their pets. A welcoming day room with activities for people who would otherwise be alone and wandering the streets. Housing and services for homeless veterans. If these agencies did not exist, more than 90% of the homeless men, women, and children in our community would go without help.
Thanks, Barbara. My name is John Paul Athanasio. It's kind of like euthanasia, but close. I've had the opportunity to work with Barbara for 4 years now, and again, got involved because of the tours, because a lady at church got me involved with our food pantry, and then got started with the tours. And if you've not been on one of the tours, I think the next one's November the 15th. I would encourage you to make that leap of faith and do that. So, we've lived in Amarillo for 21 years, and in my opinion, we're a pretty great community. You, as people in Amarillo, are very compassionate. You care about people, and you're very generous with your resources. And we're thankful for that because your resources is what makes it happen for us as we help those agencies that we try to support. The preparation for the luncheon begins in June as the volunteers from the recipient agencies join forces with the members of the committee and the Interfaith Campaign for the Homeless Committee. And we work together to make this happen. It takes a lot of effort. Takes lots of meetings, and Bobby leads us, and we're real fortunate to have all the other people that are involved in those committees serving in so many different ways to make this happen. As this occurs, the campaign committee members continue to seek funds from individuals, businesses, organizations, communities of faith, and foundations. We ask a lot. And we like talking to you because it's a 50-50 chance that we'll get either a yes or a no. We like the yeses better than we like the noes, but we still like asking. The Beans and Cornbread Luncheon is a kickoff luncheon for the campaign. Approximately half of the funds raised from this luncheon today and the funds raised from the campaign will be the amount that we have, you know, when we reach the final destination in May. Last year we raised $121,000. We had $121,000 now. And that came from the Catherine E. Grady Fund, a component fund of Amarillo Area Foundation. We're so thankful for, you know, Amarillo Area Foundation and you know, their commitment to, you know, to our community. $242,000 is great, but we left $58,000 on the table because we have $150,000 match if we reach, you know, $150,000. So we don't want to leave, you know, $58,000 on the table this year. You know, we want to raise the whole $150,000 and receive $150,000 match. And that can only happen because of you and because of people that you know, people that you can share the story with, because we've got some great stories. And these 17 agencies that we supported last year, you know, those people that are involved on the day-to-day just do a great job. Today, if you look around, you see your friends, you see neighbors, you see business associates, you know, you see people from communities of faith that you worship with, you know, Beans and Cornbread committee members, interfaith committee members, so many people that you know, and they're all passionate about helping people. You know, that's why we do this. We're all volunteers, you know, to make this happen. So, you know, we want to make sure, you know, that this year that $150,000, you know, is reached. It's a journey for the next few months as we talk to you and you listen when we tell you the stories, and we have an opportunity, you know, to keep moving forward, because we don't want to leave $58,000 on the table this year. You know, we want to raise $150,000 and receive that match from the Kathleen Bailey Fund, you know, component fund of Amarillo Area Foundation. We're just so blessed. Glad to live in Amarillo. It's a great community, and glad you guys are here.
So again, we do have a little bit of time now moving forward. If you'd like to sneak back to the silent auction table, you are welcome to do so. The silent auction again is open until 12:45. 12:45 on the nose. And we are going to shut that down. But again, all of the donations provided through the silent auction items today help us to reach that goal of $150,000 as we continue to try and do that. So thanks again to the Amarillo Area Foundation and the Catherine E. Grady Fund, and giving up to, again, $150,000. We're going to drill that number into our brains until we get it. We will. There's an empty envelope at your seat. If you are interested in giving to support those agencies, you are welcome to fill that envelope. Someone will come by and pick that up later in the program. And of course, the checks can be made out to Beans and Cornbread, care of the Amarillo Area Foundation. And that is where you put your $10 for your plant friend who you want to take home from your table as well. So don't forget about that. So again, thank you very much to the Amarillo Area Foundation. Thank you for being here, all of you. And please enjoy the rest of the program.
My name is Chris Israel. I'm from Amarillo now. Originally, I'm from the East Coast, by way of a lot of different places. Immediately before Amarillo, I was in Denver. Before that, I was up in Canada. And before that, I was in New Jersey. I've been a nomad for 20 years. My most serious bout of homelessness started just outside of Amarillo. Somehow I ended up in Port Talis. And in Port Talis, I was probably at the spot that is your true rock bottom. And I picked up a phone and called a veterans crisis line with the last 50 cents in my pocket. And the veterans crisis people connected me to the Amarillo VA, and a social worker picked up and said, "You need to get to Amarillo. There's no services in Port Talis. There is a clinic in Clovis, that can help you get to Amarillo. So I walked from Portales to Clovis, and I bags and bags. Along the way, I'm leaving bags full of stuff, you know? And, you know, I'm stashing them places under rocks and, you know, under giant boulders along the side of the road. I'm just dropping pieces of myself. I mean, one of those bags had my wrestling shoes in it that, you know, and it had my stuff of my life in that bag. Ultimately, I'm there with what I can carry. The Clovis Clinic, they adopted me for the most part. They were feeding me, they were offering me money, and I was sleeping in an empty building. So it's the winter of 2015, right? And it's snowing in Clovis. Freak snowstorms, right? Like 20-degree weather, 10-degree weather. 5 or 6 days later, they came out and said, hey, your records are in Amarillo, you can get on the bus tomorrow. It's 4 years I've been in Amarillo, and every year has been just this much better than the last year. And those first couple of years were hard years. You know, working at the VA is no joke as a janitor, you know? But without that experience, I'm still a janitor at the VA. I uniquely understand what it's like to be homeless, especially in the city of Amarillo. As long as I'm in Amarillo, I'm not allowing somebody to live in a shed at Lowe's or live on a loading dock or drop their bags along the way.
Good afternoon, my name is Bobby Nixon. I am the chair of the Beans and Cornbread Luncheon Committee that we are so honored that each of you are at today. Right about 4 years ago, I met Chris. Most of you in this room know that I work for Another Chance House Men's Shelter here locally in town. And part of our program is our veterans program. Chris said he arrived in Amarillo in 2015. His first 30 days, he stayed at Salvation Army because that was the only viable option he had at that time after that bus ride from Clovis. But about 30 days after he was here, he was introduced to Another Chance House Veterans Program. And the first time I met Chris, had a beard, looked like an individual who had been lost for a little while, and I know a little bit about that. So one of the first things that we used to implement at Another Chance House was that you were clean shaven, and he had to shave his beard. And through his video, I have come to understand that he still resents that moment. But he came to Another Chance House, and he was actually a very quiet individual, stayed to himself. I actually thought he kind of isolated, that he needed to be more involved. And the truth was, is that I was meeting a person who was diligent, who had hit rock bottom and decided to claw his way out. After coming to Another Chance House, he got a part-time job working for one independent local landscaper, making about $30 a day. But fortunately, by being in the veterans program, he could save all of his money because he didn't have to pay to be there. The VA took care of that for him. So he started saving his money. He was there 6 months. That's how long they're allowed to stay. He acquired a HUD-VASH voucher. That is a Veteran Affairs Supplemental Housing Voucher. He got his first apartment. This is all in his 4 years since today. Got his first apartment, which had no furniture. So with a donated veterans blanket that was handmade by one of the ladies who brings them to our veterans, and some permanently borrowed Another Chance House pillows, he furnished his first apartment, slept on the floor, another beginning. During this time, he applied and got a job at the Veterans Administration here locally, working as a janitor, full-time. Continued to work on himself, started paying his own way back. Within 1 year, he was paying for his own apartment, no longer on the VASH program. He has furnished his own apartment. He has since become full-time employed at VetStar, which is housed at our Family Support Services building. And what VetStar does is rapid rehousing for homeless veterans. Just like his message said, in the end, as long as I'm in Amarillo, I'm going to continue battling the epidemic of our homeless veteran population starting in Amarillo. If that's not diligence, I do not know what is. But I'm here to tell you today that annually, the Beans and Cornbread Luncheon Committee selects our Victorious Heart recipient, and what that is an individual who has experienced homelessness or at-risk homelessness, has worked so hard on themselves, has utilized one or more of the local programs to help bring themselves out of that situation, and I am honored today to present to you the 21st Annual Beans and Cornbread Victorious Heart recipient, Chris Israel.
Since and long before I needed it 5 years ago. When I landed in Amarillo, I didn't have two nickels to rub together. These people were there. They provided guidance and direction and resources, and I am where I am today in no small part thanks to many of them. I've been on canvas. I've been under the canvas. I've slept in a shed, in a parking lot. I've been cold and hungry. I've been worn down. I've been beaten down. I've stayed in the Salvation Army and other homeless shelters. I've lived at another chance house. I've had a HUD-VASH voucher. I've worked as a janitor at the VA. And I've worked really hard to try and end veterans homelessness in Amarillo in my current position with VetStar. I don't make tons of money, but this is the best job I've ever had. It's directly impactful every day. We work crazy hours, and I have a team of colleagues that make it happen every day. Some of them knew me when. Kathy Caldwell is the social worker at the VA that picked up that call on the Veterans Crisis Line that day in Dallas. She works at the VA on the fourth floor, and I know her personally. We're colleagues now. Verlene Dixon. Verlene was a case manager at the Salvation Army at the time when I was there. She got me my first job and was washing windows and then pushing a lawnmower. Jim Womack. He is the director of Family Support Services. And I actually applied for Verlene's job before there was a Veterans Resource Center. And let me tell you, the best, most qualified person got that position in Verlene. She is a godsend in this area for veterans. Bobby Nixon is the director, assistant director at Another Chance House now. You know, I'm sorry, he was a pain in my ass when I was in his program, but he is, you know, dedicated beyond all dedication. I can't say how much I appreciate him. Juliana Kitten was the chief of Hapadana Housing First program at the VA and a huge cheerleader for my success. She actually recommended me for the position I have now at VetStar. There's this guy at the VA, his name is Lance. He's the old Marine that drove me from Clovis to Amarillo. We actually became friends, and he told me to get my foot in the door at the VA, and that it would be okay. And it's okay. Dave Lewis, the old director of VetStar, a retired fighter pilot, who saw something in me and knew that this was the work that I needed to be doing. My supervisor, Corey Lucas, the director of VetStar, Greg Gittner, and my Amarillo team, Bobby Rodriguez and Robert Bridges, we are doing the good work and we are being recognized for it nationally. My friend and colleague, Shiloh Dubois, who inspires me every morning with her smile and dedication to helping other people. Fight the fight, sister. My veteran navigators at the Veterans Resource Center, Danny, Jimmy, and Ben, you guys are the best team they have ever assembled to do veterans work, and you guys are getting it done. The members of the continuum of care for the homeless, do not let off the gas. We are making a difference. I often see folks that were at some of these places while I was homeless, and they're always like, "You made it." And I'm like, "I'm getting there." The last thing that Google said was, "Your speech need has to be short." So please don't make the government agencies take care of the homeless. They are not good at it. The community agencies and nonprofits in town are the real boots on the ground. They have people like me, they have people like you that care about what is happening to the homeless in our community. And it is our job to care for the people that can't care for themselves. Be generous when you give. If you want to put stipulations on your giving, I'm okay with that. But all these organizations need your help, whether it's time as a volunteer, or making sandwiches with Amarillo Brown Bag Runs, or donating furniture and clothing, or attending a fundraiser. Do what you can, because While we often say they, the homeless, need to just pull themselves up by their bootstraps, some of those folks, they don't have feet. Thank you.
Now the CIT, I would consider them the experts when it comes to these things because we deal with it every day and we make it a priority for dealing with these things. So it's the other officers that may not know those things. Well, that's where we become their resource. So whenever they're having a hard time figuring out what can I do here, they call a CIT officer. So it works both ways. That's what I like about it is that it helps all the way around.
So somebody who is chronically homeless, is probably not choosing to be homeless. They have mental health issues. They have addiction challenges. There may be disabilities involved, like a physical disability rather than just mental health, medical, addiction. It's how you really define it. Those are all disabilities that an individual has to address. When we look at our numbers in Amarillo, we are seeing that 91% to 95% of the homeless in our community are in shelters. They are not the folks that you typically see in a B-roll on a news story where, it may be folks pushing a grocery basket or living under the gazebo out by the resource center or at the tent city or something like that. Most of our homeless are what I think of as unseen homeless. And they are unseen because their kids get on a school bus in the morning, and then they go to work, or they go over to ARAD because a van comes and picks them up, and they are putting their lives back together through the programs that are offered through our multiple homeless shelters in Amarillo.
The fact that there are as many services as there are, I think, speaks to the variety of needs that there are in the community. And as I said before, everybody's not the same. Everybody doesn't need the same thing. Everybody, it's not one size fits all. And so I think that there are lots of kind of niche programs, if you will, that are very specific to a certain population, and I think that that's helpful. For example, programs for veterans, programs for homeless men, programs for women, women with children, you know, all those kinds of things. And so I think that having so much, it just makes the possibilities so much greater for people to get better and to get what they really need. As much as it would be wonderful to think that someday there would be some giant holistic treatment facility that offers everything and people can just walk in one end and out the other end and be better, but we're not there, you know? So the next best thing, I think, is kind of joining hands with all of the organizations in the community, pulling it all together, knowing about each other, communicating with each other, supporting each other in our efforts, and championing one another, and doing what we can to support the clientele, the participants in each of the programs, you know. So a lot of the time, there's crossover, you know, and you know, we get to see the benefits of different programs.
For the past 23 years, the Amarillo Area Foundation and the Don and Sybil Harrington Foundation have been honored to support the Interfaith Campaign for the Homeless by providing matching funds for all contributions received during the year. This year, we continue that tradition by providing $150,000 worth of matching support from the Amarillo Area Foundation's Catherine E. Brady Fund. Do everything you can to help homeless residents in Amarillo and our region, and help us make a difference in people's lives today.
We know that there are many causes that lead people to homelessness or create the risk of homelessness. So, as many causes as there are or as many risk factors as there are, we need that those varying types of services to meet those needs. And we need to tailor our services to what those individual needs are. And I think that this community has done a very excellent job with that. And I think one of the great things about this community, and I've worked in a lot of different communities, and I think it's unique in Amarillo, is the incredible collaboration.
We are all working on resolving homelessness. Okay, that's what we're working on.
Our literate still, and that's gonna just create additional barriers for them and being able to.
And these folks didn't have stability in the mom and dad throughout that period of time. They may have been in multiple different places.
If they're in elementary school, for all their time in elementary school, they have the same counselor, they have the same principal. So that's a stability that gives them and shows them that the homeless cycle that their family may have been in for years and years and years and years and years, they can change that.
You know, we can't force it on them. We can't sit here and say, go into Martha's home. We have a bed, you know, you'll have food and shelter, your basic needs provided. I think a lot of that stems from mental health issues and the scary part of going back into that trauma.
Partner who they read in order to jumpstart that recovery.
So when we work with someone, we see someone that has experienced trauma and trust, it can take days and years for us to create enough trust to hand them off to Downtown Women's Center or to spend time at the park or to be able to stay in a domestic violence shelter long enough to experience safety and think about the next thing.
So I feel very fortunate that we have a community that really focuses on so many levels, from the Pavilion, Texas Panhandle Centers.
And I love the compassion in the heart that comes out. And I love the fact that we all work together.
We are investing in lives. That's what we do every day.
Raise money primarily through my community faith.
to contribute to the Beans and Cornbread luncheon, and then after the Beans and Cornbread luncheon. So I just think if people could see what you do, they would want to help.
Information and referral for the majority of the programs in our communities that provide services, whether it's food, whether it's shelter, maybe help with rent or utilities, maybe they need help with furniture if they've just gotten into a home. So any health and human service need that you can think of, we get phone calls for. We take about 40,000 calls a year. Folks can go on our website also, 211texas.org, and they're able to search for services themselves. We have a lot of people who associate, unfortunately, shame sometimes with their situation in life. So it gives them the opportunity to search for services on their own. Our services are open to anybody in the community who has a need. It's not any special demographic, one over the other. However, we do get a lot of calls from people who are homeless and at risk to becoming homeless.
I'm impressed so much by the heart for giving in this community. I've lived a lot of places and I've never witnessed anything quite like Amarillo.
Hey, Chris, do you want your award? I thought he left it up here for me. I really didn't know. No. So again, each year, the Beans and Cornbread Luncheon Committee selects an individual. It's called the Golden Heart Award. It is designated for an individual or a organization or a business or a group that go above and beyond the heart of giving. This year's recipient started at the Tyler Street Resource Center, which is now known as Guy on Saunders, after a long career as a prison guard. He shared with the staff that he took this position because he felt led by God to go there. Many of us, including myself, did not know that at this time he had a brother who was homeless off and on and was at that time receiving services through the Tyler Street Resource Center. He has, over the years, been highly successful in assisting individuals because he is a very steady influence in their daily life. He has the ability to accept all people without judgment and to work to the fullest to make sure that their basic needs are met. He successfully organizes summer and winter outreaches and has for several years, and partnered with the VA to bring much-needed supplies to those experiencing homelessness. He has participated in every point-in-time count, that is an annual count, of the homeless population in Amarillo, including sheltered and non-sheltered individuals. He is instrumental in partnering with several local agencies for donations to supplement the budget of the Gone Saunders Day Running. Homeless individuals know this man, they trust this man because he does not judge them. He accepts them for who they are, where they're at, and he just loves them. These qualities have fostered trust and made it possible to move on with many of these individuals that he deals with on a daily basis. He exemplifies do unto others as you would have them do unto you. And at this time, if you would please join me in recognizing our Golden Heart recipient for the 21st Annual Beans and Cornbread Luncheon, Mr. Brian Gillespie. Let me just take a moment here to catch my breath. Fourteen years ago, I set out on a you could call it a call of God. I felt that he was leading me somewhere, so I uprooted my family from Dalhart, Texas. That's not too far, but we had steady jobs, and I moved here to Amarillo with basically nothing. I had no sure direction where I was going. That was back in 2005. I met with the director of Faith Seed Ministries and kind of told him mine and my wife's plan, that God had told me to move to Amarillo and work with the homeless, and hopefully not become homeless. Well, he may have been a little set. Skeptical, but 6 months later, there I was at one of the community caseworker meetings, working part-time for the, back then, Tyler Street Resource Center, and not having a clue what I was doing. Well, I'm happy to say, 14 years later, and I still don't have a clue as to what I'm doing. You know, that call that God gave to me, I thought it was follow me. But instead it was follow me. I have someone I want you to meet. And so I've met people, a lot of people since then. I met a man that was from Russia, and he had defected here and actually used to be part of the Russian military. And I've met a 17-year-old runaway that was trying to pass himself as Russian. Every day I see a lot at the guy on Saunders Resource Center. I see a lot that doesn't faze me, and maybe should. I see a lot of stuff that is new. And I see something new almost every day. And I see a lot of new faces almost every day. It warms my heart to know that here in Amarillo, the Amarillo community is very, very generous. And they have been generous to us. They have been generous to our homeless. But yet I'm still hurt because we still have homeless.
this award is really not for me. But it's for him. It's more of my Savior love. Because he's kept me here. It's not been me for these last 14 years. It's been him. Walking in my shoes, going, I would like you to meet someone new. And I meet them. Try to get to know a little bit about them. Try to make them feel comforted. Because some days, most days, it feels like there's not a lot that I can do for them. But hopefully I can be there. Be a listening ear. Maybe be a caring heart. I want to say thank you to everyone out here today supporting the Interfaith Campaign for the Homeless. I want to say thank you to all my directors that have come through and taught me, helped me believe in myself so that I could share that with someone else and they can help believe themselves. I would like to say thank you to the committee. I would like to say thank you, City of Amarillo, for allowing us to go out and do what we do. Thank you, everybody.
He has loved, he has helped, he has shown endless empathy. He never puts himself first and is always there when called upon. The countless hours spent, the countless tears shed. When he could have shed them due to circumstances in his own life, he didn't. He shed them for others. He always looks up and always shines his light. Not once, no matter how bad it may have been for him, did he stop shining for others. Life has thrown its fair share of curveballs. Some have been easy to overcome, and others have presented years of challenges and hurdles. Those challenges and hurdles have only made him stronger. I know there were times when he wanted to give up, throw in the towel, and let life go as it did, but he never did. There were many people there for him and offering help, and there was help that he didn't always take. Finally, there was a light, the light that he is now for others, a constant source of inspiration to all who know him. A loving son, husband, father, brother, friend, and mentor. Someone to turn to during those times that seem unbearable. He has touched so many lives and never expected anything in return. His presentations always stand out, partially due to his own story. Today, we want to say thank you. Today, we want to say thank you for picking us up when we are down. Thank you for listening. Thank you for sharing in our troubles and providing solutions. Thank you for chairing countless committees and making sure the events are so successful. Thank you for all of the big bear hugs. You always seem to know just when we need them. You lead us with charisma and a commitment that we cannot duplicate. We are lucky to have you. And today, we want you to know that. Our world is a better place because you are in it. We want you to know how much we appreciate you and how deeply we love you. And for all of those reasons and many more, it is my honor to present the 2018 Mayor Rafkin Legacy Award to Mr. Bobby Nixon.
And I'm so grateful it was there. I'm grateful for a program working with the Salvation Army that told me that I didn't belong there. And I shared with him that I had nowhere to go. I burned the bridges with my family and my friends. He told me about another chance house. I've told this story before. The scariest female I've ever heard in my life answered that phone. I lived at another chance house for almost 6 years, 5.5 years. It took me 5.5 years to retrain myself and understand that there was a good way of life out there, that my life mattered. I'm stubborn, I'm hard-headed. That's why it took me 6 years, I'm just telling you. But all along the way, many, many, many individuals in this community helped me when I needed help the most. I worked at another chance house for a little over 10 years, different roles. I've learned that having the opportunity to give back what's given to you is the most precious gift that you can give. It is an honor to be an individual who provides services for the homeless population in this city, because I love Amarillo because it loved me first. It didn't give up on me, and it let me know that I had something, I had a gift. I have a gift to help others, and that's what we do, every one of us. If there is an individual in this room who works for an organization that provides services for the homeless or their at-risk homeless, would you please stand at this moment and be recognized, because your work is the power that happens in this community every day. Please. This is what we need help with. Every life matters. I was fortunate enough to find that out. And today, I'm fortunate to be able to work with so many wonderful individuals. The committee of the Beans and Cornbread luncheon today, you are my rock. Because I don't have to manhandle anything. It's about encouraging and working with each other to put on such a wonderful event. And just know that as long as I am a part of this event, I will continue doing whatever I can to make Amarillo better. Let's end homelessness. That's why we're here. Thank you.
as I think back with facing Mission Salvation Army, Family Support Services, with the safe house that they have been around a really long time. But 30 years ago or so, that's when Martha's Home started in 1987, and then another Chance House came about in 1988, and then down to Women's Center in 1989.
Homelessness exists on several different levels. It exists, you know, in that high school student. It exists in older adults that life happened and they lost a job. They had medical issues, and when they have those medical issues and those bills, you know, mount up. I mean, you just feel hopeless. You know that you can't, you know, make a difference. And because one of our agencies can step in and, you know, help them move from, you know, whatever that issue is, you know, to, you know, being more self-sufficient.
Sometimes success is just securing a safe place to be. Sometimes success is getting a meal for that day.
And there's always going to be a very small percentage that don't want help. They want to live on the street, and that's their privilege.
Anybody that's breathing has a chance, period. Doesn't matter what they did yesterday or what they're going to do tomorrow. As long as they're breathing, they have a chance.
People who are in that situation, sometimes it's so basic, finding a place to lay your head at night. You know, that's success. For people who have children, making sure that their children are safe, even though they're on the street, that's success.
When you see somebody on the side of the street asking for money, when you see somebody sitting on the street that has no shoes and hasn't bathed in 5 days, there are places in our community that they can go to and make a connection with somebody who's trying to provide services to them. So creating that relationship and getting somebody to come into a building and take a shower is a huge, huge success for them, and it's a step in the right direction.
The more we can do with our goal, and I think we have a very clear goal with our continuum of care. It's a lofty goal, but our goal is to end homelessness. And I know that we all want to do that, but we can only do it with the support of everybody. There's not one single group that can do it.
It's about feeding your heart, feeding your soul, and helping others. And, you know, do I make a ton of money now? I don't make a ton of money, but I have more money now in my pocket because I'm so busy at work, I don't have time to spend.
The work is hard and it's difficult, and people aren't doing it for a paycheck. They're doing it because it's their mission, it's their heart, it's their passion. The only way we are gonna be able to sort of continue to do what we're doing, the great work we're already doing, and go even further, is with both continued support and enhanced support from our community providers, because truly, it is a community issue. This isn't something just that social service providers need to deal with, because homelessness affects all of us.
It's so easy when we're comfortable in our own lives and we have all the resources and all the comforts around us to forget, or maybe we never knew what it's like to just not even have your basic needs met on a daily basis. So acquiring or attaining any of those basic needs on a daily basis for homeless persons is success.
I'm the lead case guy at that star here in Amarillo, and that's a hard job, but there's nothing I would rather do than solve the homeless veteran epidemic in this country, starting with Amarillo.
Amarillo has a tremendous opportunity because of they already have this great network of this collaboration of people who do come together and do support each other. But if we're gonna really get over that hump, I think we need even more enhanced support from other members of our community besides our social service providers.
Does anyone else have a surprise award that we need to know about before we
We're okay. So thank you. Thank you for being here. I know we are short on time. Your participation today is so important to our goal to end homelessness in Amarillo. Again, our goal, we have a number on that. We can put it on paper. It's $150,000, and we need your generosity today. We're asking you to give. We are asking you to give to this campaign. We are asking you to give to all of these organizations who are teaming up together to help in our community end homelessness. What an incredible achievement that would be if we as a community could say, we did it. There is no homelessness in Amarillo anymore. We will not stand for that. Now is your chance. Now is your chance to be generous, to give generously. There are several opportunities for you to do so. There's a great way that you can do it on your phone. I think we have maybe like a screenshot. The Amarillo Area Foundation's website has a very obvious donate now button. That's an easy way to do that. Volunteers are at the back. They're waiting to help you as well. If you'd rather give that way, they can process credit card donations or debit cards. There are those envelopes on your tables. You can give there. You'll want to, you know, again, figure out, discuss who's taking the plant friend home from Bruins Greenhouse. So you have that conversation rolling anyway. Again, help us. $150,000 will be matched by the generosity of the Amarillo Area Foundation. And so let's reach that goal today. Let's do that. Please consider your selection. Consider what you can do today. And as you're doing that, the River Road Choir is going to sing for us one more time as we do that. The silent auction is closed. No elbows. No throwing elbows. It's closed. We did it. They're good. So, you know, hopefully you got what you needed from the silent auction. So here's the River Road Choir again. Just a few minutes to consider how generously you can give today. Also, if you would like a volunteer to come and get the envelope from you, you can hold it in the air and they'll be happy to do that too. I know.
Constitute. of all the world thy hands have made.
Has been 2 decades plus. It is the launching event of the interfaith campaign.
211 is a 3-digit easy number to dial.
It will save you a lot of time and trouble if the numbers in front of you while dialing. Well, let's use this demonstration model for a moment while we dial our number.
So what I've learned over the past 18 years is that
it's exhausting and I'm going to die before we accomplish our goal.
I was shocked by the deed and by some of the stories I read. I did not realize how bad people's lives could be. I forgot to make it.
Then sings my